Kerala has become a manufacturing hub of graduates and postgraduates and PhDs, and these days engineers and even IAS officers and civil servants. We give so much importance to degrees and white-collar jobs. When we come to skills and skills training, there's hardly an institute of repute or quality. Why do we shun skills? Why do we shun blue-collar jobs? Why do we all want to be in air-conditioned offices? Why do we want to be MBAs and software engineers? To discuss this and all its related issues, we have three very young people with us, people who are themselves aspiring for white-collar jobs. We have Gauri. Have you ever done any physical work in your life? Have you ever waited at a table? Have you ever washed dishes in a restaurant? Have you ever done any carpentry work?
Not in the practical aspect, but in my home I do everything.
So. No, but as a worker outside, have
no.
you?
No.
No. Why is that?
Because I think it's because of the way we are brought up, the society, the way the people or the society look at the white collar, as in the blue collar jobs. So we prefer, especially women, we prefer to be doing the white collar job rather than the blue collar job.
And we have Vishal. Why did you choose economics? Why didn't you do, why didn't you want to do a degree or a diploma in carpentry or masonry?
From my childhood onwards, I had a wish. I wanted to go in the same line of economics. So that's why I took my ambition. I wanted to go with my ambition. That's why I took a good decision taking economics. I didn't want to go for carpentry because I had an ambition from my childhood. So I needed to go to the right way.
And then we have Sneha. Would you like to do a blue-collar job, Sneha?
As of now, I don't have such interest, and I'm not skilled in such in many of the things. And if I get some training, I would like to do some
job. If the government gave you training, would you go for a blue-collar job?
Yes.
Okay. And the guest for tonight is somebody who really needs no introduction. It's Mr. Vijayaraghavan. Let me ask you this. Do you think, Vijayaraghavan, that ultimately Mahatma Gandhi failed? Mahatma Gandhi was someone who taught us to work with our hands. He cleaned his own toilets, he washed his clothes, he even manufactured salt in the sea in Dundee. But today nobody wants to do any manual labor, any blue-collar work. Why is that?
I think it's not Gandhi had failed. If you look at Gandhi, whether Gandhi had failed or not, in many ways, yes. I mean, values.
In this aspect,
maybe to some extent, in values, definitely there. But definitely there is the aspiration levels, especially of the Malayali, are very, very high. So after class 10, when there was no option to get a good job, and for most Malayalis over the last 20, 25 years, a good job is something where you sit at a desk and work and not do things with your hands.
Is it something to do with our society? Does society discourage blue-collar work? Intergenerationally, do we think that it is bad to do blue-collar work? Is there something to do with society? Gauri?
Actually, there is a certain social stigma attached to the blue-collar jobs. But reality is that the white-collar jobs, it guarantees a sense of security. People have a secure feeling if you are placed in a white-collar job. If in a blue-collar job, it could be seasonal. It need not give you a steady income. So people always prefer white-collar jobs.
Is it to do with incomes or is it to do with a feeling of stigma in society?
No, I think it's mostly because of the security of the job. Because it's seasonal, so they don't get always job. Like if it comes in a rainy season, they won't be having much. So I believe that job security, they might not have an alternative. So the income at that time, you should just look about the income at that time, at that season. They won't be having that much of what they had before. So it changes.
Is it really to do with economics? Is it to do with money? Or
I don't think it's to do with money. Because if it were to do with money, how would you have people working in shops, sales girls, young sales boys at salaries of 2,000, 2,500 rupees, when you have a mason or a helper getting 400, 500 rupees a day for working maybe from 8 to 3 or 8 to 4. So what really, it is not money. That's very clear. But also there is one more thing. Somehow people shirk hard work. There is a feeling that it is, I don't want to work very hard. Every parent wants their child to be doing better than them. At the same time, the Malayali had no problem going to the Middle East and working as a mason, carpenter, or a driver. There was no problem. But the same person would not want to do that work here.
Why is that? Is that again because of the social stigma that you spoke about, Gauri?
Yeah, it's because the society is not looking at you. Here, yeah. we are working in our own environment, our own society, so people are looking at us.
So you're scared. You
yeah,
don't want
to. Scared.
Yeah.
So if you go outside, nobody's looking at you. Nobody cares whether you are a mason there or whether you are a CEO there. It's just that, okay, he's doing his job
all
in
Dubai.
Yeah, all are equal. Yeah,
all are equal.
NRIs.
Yeah.
A blue-collar job is not equal to a white-collar job.
In this society.
In
right.
Society.
How do you change that society? Vishak, you're young. Sneha, you're young. How will you change this?
We need to bring the younger generation to think about it.
How
we
do you make them to think about it? How do you change the aspiration levels?
Look, it's not what will happen at some point of time. This
right.
will change.
Yes.
If you look at the West,
yes.
You would have students who go part-time and work in restaurants.
Right.
We don't have. Not that we don't have openings in restaurants here.
Yeah, yeah.
I'm sure most restaurants will be very happy to take a few people in the evenings.
Mm-hmm.
But you don't do that because mm-hmm. the family says, oh my God, that I don't want my son to be doing
yes.
that.
Yes,
but
yes,
the
yes.
same family doesn't mind the son or daughter
uh-huh.
who is going to the US or the UK or Singapore
yeah.
working part-time in a restaurant.
No problems there.
Whether it's at McDonald's
yeah.
or a small Indian
yeah.
restaurant,
yeah.
they don't mind work. So I think the whole thing is about how we perceive others looking at us.
Yes.
Yeah.
Vishak, you heard Mr. Vijayaraghavan. You don't, would you, during your holidays, go and work in a chaya kada? If they give you a lot of money?
Yeah, I would have given a choice.
Gauri, will you work?
No.
No? Why?
Because I'm an MBA graduate.
Oh, you are an MBA graduate.
Yeah.
No, you can't do that
no,
one.
No, not that.
Absolutely not.
So
Rajiv Gandhi, if I remember right, met Sonia
it.
Gandhi in one of those.
The aspiration that I have is
yeah.
different.
Right.
Being an MBA graduate, I want to manage people. In the sense, I want to make people work and do my work.
You want to be the boss.
Yeah.
But why is that? Can't you not make people work even as a carpenter? You can be the... what do you call that? The
master craftsman.
I believe so. Those people need certain kind of skills. It is not just the money that attracts them. You need certain kind of skill because you need, in the beginning itself, you need to visualize how it will look at the end if you're building a house. So you need to have certain skill sets for that. I don't think I have that.